Our next speaker is Donald McPherson. He's been in Vancouver for a long time, since 1986. In 1987, he worked at the Carnegie Community Center in the downtown East Side, so he has strong roots to this riding as well. And he's also worked with the City of Vancouver. In the year 2000, he became the first drug policy coordinator for the City of Vancouver. He recently left his job with the City of Vancouver to work with others across Canada on the development of a national civil society network on drug policy. Donald is currently the director of the Canadian Drug Policy Coalition, which is a national civil organization with the goal of advancing improvements to Canadian drug policy. And he's also a member of Stop the Violence BC. It's your floor there, Donald.
Thank you, and for that introduction. And I want to say thank you for having this meeting. I think what Steve said, and you know, your words about your policy discussion and your vote at the last convention is significant, and it's not out of line with the stuff that's happening around the world in other countries. This is just part of a much bigger global movement that is witnessing the failure of what Steve was talking about, the drug prohibition. It really is not sustainable financially, ethically, morally. It's great to be able to have this kind of discussion. In many, we're a nonpartisan organization, the Canadian Drug Policy Coalition. As Mark said, I left my job at the City of Vancouver after many, many years of working in the downtown East Side. I just live over here on Templeton and Adnack. So, you know, I know the hood, I know the downtown East Side very well, and my experience comes very much more from sort of the harm reduction perspective, public health perspective. I've learned a lot more from people like Jody and Mark and some of the others in this room around the whole cannabis discussion. So you wanted someone to talk about. I'm not a health professional. I'm a generalist. I'm someone who's pushed for progressive, evidence-based public policies in the area of drug policy for the last 15, 20 years. Was really inspired by some of the people in the downtown East Side, some of the people who are not with us anymore, who have died. I just came from the Vancouver Area Network of Drug Users meeting, where they were talking about the ethics of research and the fact that we don't need any more research. You know, we know enough. There's enough knowledge about how to help people with severe addictions. What we need is actual a broad array of services to help people. The Canadian Drug Policy Coalition is, I brought a few of these papers, I only have about 10 left, we're printing some more. We're trying to build a movement in Canada that acknowledges many of the things Steve was talking about, many of the things that Jody will talk about, that we need to move beyond this sort of blanket prohibition of drugs and move towards a public health approach to respond to people who have problems with drugs. And lots of people do, as we know. Lots of people have severe problems with drugs, and that's where our focus needs to be. How can we help people who develop problems with drugs? The issue of, you know, criminalization of drug use and people using drugs, possession of drugs, is beginning to become irrelevant in a sense that countries are moving away from the criminalization of people who use drugs, and that's one of the I'll talk about five policy areas that this is sort of our a very short brief sort of why we need change, and we want to talk about five policy areas that we think could make a significant change to the Canadian public along in terms of social, economic, development, and public health and we think that we've seen the discussion in Vancouver of how to respond to severe addiction, injection drug abuse, HIV epidemics, overdose epidemics. We've seen the battle. We've had just to keep a very small program in place called Insight that's been operating now for 9 years. Tremendous amount of energy has gone into that on all sides. Probably way too much, but it's an important symbolic program. And it's very well researched, and it's a good thing. But in this political context, we can't scale this up. I mean, Insights are really, they should be just, if you go to Europe, if you go to Germany, Switzerland, the Netherlands, they're just things they do. They're not the be all and end all. They're just part of an array of more comprehensive approach. Yes, you need injection rooms, but you also need housing, you need these other types of facilities. So we really need to sort of get beyond the Insight model and to try and just accept that as part, like we do with syringe exchanges. We have syringe exchanges all over the country. Every small towns, some small towns have it. So one of our main policy areas is to try and move that discussion forward in the country. Sort of take a comprehensive approach to responding to people who have problems with drugs. Another policy area is to sort of look at that we could decriminalize people who develop drug problems do not need to be criminalized. People who use substances and are no problem themselves or anyone else do not need to be criminalized. It's a waste of time and energy. It takes the focus away from the types of interventions we can do to help people. We want to have a discussion. We take a position on regulation of drugs. We don't talk about legalization. We talk about regulation. And I'm sure when we get to legalizing cannabis and regulating cannabis, we'll have big debates on how best to do that, right? Because we have lots of different opinions on how to do that, but I'm confident we'll work something out. We have to get to that point. So we want to have a national dialogue on the regulation and control of drugs, noticing, and we use the terms we use are regulation and control, noticing that drug control efforts, as Steve was saying, don't control drugs. They control people, but they don't control drugs. They actually open up a huge black market, and it's actually our current drug control policies create a free market system. Another main policy area we want to talk about is human rights, and to notice that Canada is signatory to international treaties. And what is done in the name of international drug control treaties, and what is done in the name of drug control globally, would make your head spin. People are executed. You know, if you have a chunk of heroin or cocaine in some countries, you are put to death. You know, if you have a package this big, they take your life. And that there's a whole discussion in the legal world around proportionality. You know, the sentence has to fit the crime, and if there's disproportional actions by many. 22 countries still have the death penalty for drug possession and drug dealing. In Southeast Asia, there are treatment centers where people are taken and locked away for 2 years because they have drug problems or their son was a dealer. People are grabbed off the street. They're tested for substances in their bloodstream or in their pee. If they're taken away to forced labor camps. This is all in the name of public health. This is all in the name of trying to control drugs and trying to have so-called rehabilitation programs, and there's just a litany of examples. Human Rights Watch has been involved in some of these cases and trying to get these places closed down. So that's something that we are part of because we as a country uphold the international treaties, and these actions in other countries are done in the name of drug control.